الأنبياء والمرسلين أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله
الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله
وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا حبيب الله الصلاة والسلام عليك يا نبي الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا نور الله نويت سنة الاعتكاف When you brothers every time, Alhamdulillah, we come to the Ijtima, we hear about the blessings of reciting durood upon our beloved Master sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. And amongst one of those many, many blessings is that there is a hadith in Mubarakah which says that in which the Holy Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stated that whoever writes durood-e paak upon me in a book, then for as long as that durood remains in that book, the angels of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pray for the forgiveness of that person. For as long as durood is written and remains in a book, the angels will continuously pray for you. This is one of the many blessings of reciting durood. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to be punctual in this. Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear brothers, alhamdulillah, everyone knows that this is the greatest month for a Muslim, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showered and gifted this ummah with the greatest blessing ever. And the month of the birth of our beloved Master sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the greatest ni'mat.
Marhaba.
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 Our beloved Master sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the greatest gift that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to mankind. And many ulama have mentioned the great Imam Jalaluddin Suyuti Shafi radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He has said that it is preferable for us to display happiness and to rejoice at the birth of the beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this great blessing, this great gift. And one thing about adab, one thing about love, one thing about respect that we should all keep in mind. There's one of the greatest scholars called Imam Abdul Wahhab al-Sha'rani radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He passed away in the year 973 according to the Islamic calendar. And Imam Sha'rani radiallahu ta'ala is one of the greatest Sufis. He's written a great number of books on Islam. And there's a very interesting comment that he makes. There's a comment that we should remember, which is worth remembering. It's about adab, it's about respect. Respecting the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. It's a very short comment, but very meaningful, very deep. Imam Abdul Wahhab Sha'rani rahimahullah ta'ala, he says that anything which is related to the ta'zeem of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, any action or any statement which is related to the respect and the love of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a Muslim should not argue about that action. And he should not ask for a dalil. His exact words, كُلُّ مَا مَالَ إِلَىٰ تَعْذِيمِ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ لَا يَنْبَغِي لِأَحَدٍ الْبَحْثَ فِيهِ وَلَا الْمُطَالَبَةَ بِدَلِيلٍ خَاصٍ فِيهِ فَإِنَّ ذَلِكَ سُوءُ أَدَبٍ. He says anything, any action that is related to the ta'zeem of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a Muslim shouldn't do bahth about it, he shouldn't argue about it, and he shouldn't ask for a specific dalil about that thing. He should not ask for a specific evidence about something which is related to the adab, the ta'zeem of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says this is su'ul adab. This is disrespectful. It's against adab. Now, this is a very heavy, very meaningful and deep comment made by this great 10th century scholar Imam Abdul Wahhab al-Sha'nani radiyallahu ta'ala, he said, anything that's related to the love of the Prophet, don't ask for evidences. Don't ask for proof. Asking for specific proof about something which is related to the love of our Master sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, If it increases adab, if it increases ta'zeem in the hearts of Muslims for the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, let Muslims do it. Don't ask for proof. And he said specifically, asking for proof in these kind of matters is actually disrespect. It's against adab. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shower millions and billions of blessings upon the grave of Imam Sha'rani radiallahu ta'ala anhu. This is not just a comment, it's not just a statement of ishq. It's a principle that we can do. It's like an usul of adab of our deen, and usul, a principle of ishq of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Anything that Muslims do, if it increases the ta'zeem of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if Muslims are doing it because it brings them closer to the Holy Prophet alayhi wa sallam, then even if it's something that's not been mentioned clearly in the Quran, even if it's something that's not been mentioned clearly in the hadith, even if it's something that was not done in the first three generations by the Muslims, still it's okay. Because it's to do